Hey everyone, how are you doing? You have Mike here, and this is the video that you guys have all been waiting for. We are finally going to get to testing this TNB Naturals. So I just want to give you a little bit of information about this. How to use this product is very simple. All you have to do is add 1 liter of warm water, which we're going to do that here in a couple of moments. You're pretty much set to go. So what we're going to do is we're going to start this experiment. And we're going to test a couple of different things. We're going to find out how long this product is going to last for. So every day we're going to pull out our meter. And we're going to get a ambient CO2 level of what's inside our building. And then after that, we're going to put it back in, give it a good shake. And we'll restart the process over every single day. And we'll see how far it can go along and how much it can bring back up the CO2 levels every day. Because every day once we open the zipper, we're obviously going to lose the CO2 that's inside the tent. So we're going to do two things in this. For instance, we're going to see how much it can bring back up the CO2 levels from the very first day. We're also going to see how much of it slowly decreased, because I imagine this is going to slowly decrease over time. And it should be a pretty even flow. So we should be able to find that spike, that curve as well. So, once again, this product here is supposed to be used in a 12 by 12 by 12 room foot room. So, this is quite a bit smaller. This is only a 4 by 4 by 60 inch tall tent. So, interesting to see how this is going to work. My meter does go up to 5,000 parts per million. So, anyways, let's get into the test. I hope you guys enjoy. So, what we're going to use with for this test here is we have a Perfect Prime CO2 meter and logger. So we're going to be able to log all the details of what's going on. Right now it's showing we're at about 1300 parts per million. I've been in here for about a half hour preparing for this video, so that seems to be about right. When I leave the room, it should drop back down to about 700, 600 in here, and we should be able to start our experiment. But we'll wait till it levels out before we actually start it so we can see how much the TNB works, or how well it brings it up. So we have it set to 10-minute intervals. We're going to get a reading every 10 minutes. And basically, I'll show you a little demo of what it looks like now, how it gives us our reading. And as you can see, we should be able to get a very good understanding of how well this product works with this meter and the logger that it has. So for prep for this test, what we're going to do is we are going to close off all these vents. We're going to pull tight all of our tie straps. We are going to add a fan into the tent, preferably near the bottom, just to blow everything around, keep everything circulating in here. We are not going to tape off the tents, our vents, I should say, just due to, I was watching how other people are using this. A lot of people are not. They're using them in grow tents, usually 4x4s, 5x5s, or sometimes bigger. But the tents are never really fully sealed, and I think that's more of a realistic thing. I think for most people going to use a product like this, are not going to use it in a totally sealed, basically, balloon, is what I would like to say. So there is still going to be air leaks, zippers, and so forth. So I think a real experiment would be for this year is just to put it into a tent, have everything closed, and see how it works. Now, this product here is actually rated for a, I think, 12 by 12 by 12. So we're having it here in a 2 by 4 by 60. So that's quite a bit smaller. And they're saying that it should be able to hold 1,200 parts per million in a 12 by 12 by 12, or should be able to reach up to that. So in a 2 by 4 by 60 inch tall tent, we should be topping that thing out around 2,000-3,000 at least. So if we're not getting up to that high, it's highly probably not going to be, it's not going to work in a 12 by 12 by 12 area. So I'm really interested to see how this works. This could basically top out our meter, and it could basically be experiment over until we get something bigger. I don't know. Our meter does go up to 5,000, so it's really going to be a full-out experiment. We don't know how it's going to work. I don't think that it's going to get that high, though. But we'll see. This is the whole point of the experiment. We want to find out, right? So basically in this test, what we're going to do is we're going to find out what it can do in a 2x4x60. If we find out that it's producing way more than what we needed, we'll probably redo this test. I have another one here just in case. We'll probably redo this in a 4x4 tent. as soon as my grow is done. Reason why I do that is because I have my system set up to vents outside with a filter, and I'm not going to jeopardize my grow just to do an experiment. So if for some reason that this doesn't work in this tent, we will wait and we will do it again in the 4x4 as soon as my grow is done. But we're going to give it a shot here. Anyway, we want to see. I know you guys are really interested in seeing, and I think everybody that are really interested to see how this product works. This is not a advertisement for TNB. This is not telling you to go buy this. This is just a straight-up experiment. We want to see what happens, right? So, anyways, I'm going to leave it as here, guys. And we're going to get started now. We're going to make sure all the vents are closed, pull over tight strap. We're going to put our fan in the tent, and we're going to get this test fired up and going right now. So let's get going. This tent up is sealed up about as much as we're going to get. What we're going to do now is we're going to leave the room. We're going to let the CO2 in here drop, because right now we're at 1,386 parts per million. Let's come back in a couple minutes when this is a little bit lower, and we'll go from there. Alright guys, so we're set now. I took out a couple lights just so we had some room. I left the bipolar light in here just because it's giving us light for this experiment. We're not going to leave it on and waste hydro or energy in the meantime. I've got my container here of warm water. I hope that you can all see this. 46 degrees, 116 degrees, so it's some nice hot water actually, but should do the trick. So what we're going to do is we're going to add the 1 liter of water. As you can see right now, oh, I just turned off my CO2 meter. The button's in a terrible spot if you're going to grab it from the left side. Just give it a minute here. So basically what we're going to do is just add our warm water, give it a shake, and pop our hole. So our CO2 right now is at 670 parts per million, which is really where we want it, guys. That was our goal, if you remember from our last video that we were talking about this. But anyways, so we're at 670, 680. It's going to give us a reading every 10 minutes. So let's get this stuff started here. What I'm going to do is just hang it from the roof of my tent. And I do have my fan here too, but the fan is turned off for right now, just because it's going to make noise for the camera and make it hard for you to hear me. So, but as soon as we get this ready, we'll turn that on. So here we have it. There's no turning back from here. Alright guys, that is it. So I'm going to take this out of their tent because we're going to want that in the kitchen. At least my wife will. And kind of break through the little hole here. So what I've done is we can get access to this. And let's give it a little shake. Oh, I could feel that there is a little bit of pressure off it. So that's a good sign. So now all we got to do is get this fan going. Which is here. You guys can probably hear that turn on. I'm going to reattach this back to my ceiling. And we're going to turn off this light here so we're not wasting energy. So here we have it, guys. All we gotta do now is wait. So here we have it. Okay guys, so let's give this an open here. Okay. Wow, all right. So it is about 1:30 on day 2, 1:22 actually. 2160. I believe that when I first opened it here, I got a peak and it was 2,250. So when opening, it kind of started dropping right away. So what we're going to do is we're actually going, I'm going to pull this meter out of here. We're going to get a base background. We're going to leave it out here now till this levels back out. And then what we're going to do is put it back out. We're going to get the data reading off it and try to see how long it took to actually get up to 2,200 and see if it can actually get it back up to 2,000 again when we let the... actually, what I should do is leave it open so we can see if it actually does get to 2,000 again. Sound like a plan? All right, guys, so let's take a look at the data. The data is what all you guys want to see anyway, so here it is. So let's take a look at column C. This is the one you guys really need to keep note of. All these times are just going in 24-hour increments, so it should be pretty easy to keep track of here. I don't want to mess with anything. So we placed the container in. The parts per million were at 844 parts per million. So within the first hour, it broke 1,000 parts per million. 800 from 844 up to 1,000. As you can see, 1,025 here. Then next, so hour two, it came up to 1,436. Hour three, 1,791. Okay, then to hour four, we finally hit 2,000 parts per million. 5 hours in, 2,037. Then 6 hours in, 2009. So 6 hours into the test, it really started slowing down a little bit. It actually even dropped down below 2,000 where it already hit. So you can see it made it up to 2,037 and slowly kind of dropped down to a peak. And then you can see it dropped all the way down to 1957, kind of hovered there for a little bit, and then slowly started to pick up. 1970, and then you can see prediction started to pick back up a little bit, and by 940 hit 2,000 parts per million again. From here on out, it just kept on going up. I'm not sure if this is just something that I did mix it well, but I'm wondering if just within the first 10 hours or whatever, it really starts to pick up. So anyways, 12 hours in to our test, it was at 2,272 parts per million, 13, 23, 37. I'm just going to jump it ahead now. So 15 hours and 50 minutes in the test, this is where it started dropping. So its max point was 2,488 parts per million. So 2,488 parts per million. So then by 18 hours in, 18 hours and 10 minutes in, it dropped to 2,400 parts per million. So pretty good. It kind of held it there for a little while. Another 2 hours. Anyway, it held it there for about 2 hours anyway. 22 hours in, it had dropped another 200 parts per million, so 2252, so pretty close. We had the last reading that we had got before we had pulled it out, I believe, was like 2255 or something, so it was really close, 2250 or something like that. So like I said, this is here is where it was. This is the first 24 hours, and so you guys can see it as a visual thing, I had made a little chart down here so you could see first hour, and see by 1 hour all the way up to 24 hours, and you can see how it kind of went. So this here is the first 24 hours of our CO2 test using the TNB Naturals. So you guys are gonna have to stay tuned. We'll get you more as soon as this test is over, and we'll go through all of this data so we can just show you just data so you guys can actually see hard data on the TNB Naturals and how it works. So thank you guys all for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed, and have yourself a great day.